Welcome to a lesson on graphing the square root function and vertical and horizontal stretches of the square root function. Let's start by graphing the basic square root function f of x equals the square root of x. Since the square root of a negative number is not real, the domain of this function would be x greater than or equal to 0. We'll graph this by completing a table of values. To do this, we'll select x values that are perfect squares. So, for example, 0 squared is 0, 1 squared is 1, 2 squared is 4, and 3 squared is 9. This will make finding y very convenient. If x is equal to 0, y is equal to the square root of 0, which is 0. If x is equal to 1, y is equal to the square root of 1, or 1. When x is equal to 4, y is equal to the square root of 4, or 2. And when x is 9, y is equal to the square root of 9, or 3. So now we'll plot these points and sketch our graph. So we have 0, 0, 1, 1, 4, 2, and 9, 3. So here's the graph of the basic square root function. Now let's compare this to the graph of g of x equals 2 times the square root of x. And notice our coordinate plane already contains the graph of the basic square root function for easy comparison. Notice again the domain of this function is still going to be x greater than or equal to 0 because we have x underneath the square root. So we'll use the same x values, 0, 1, 4, and 9. When x is 0, notice y is going to be equal to 2 times the square root of 0, which is still 0. When x is 1, y is equal to 2 times the square root of 1. Will it be 2 times 1 or 2? When x is 4, y is equal to 2 times the square root of 4, or 2 times 2, that's 4. And when x is 9, y is equal to 2 times the square root of 9, or 2 times 3, which is equal to 6. So if we plot these four points, we have 0, 0, 1, 2, 4, 4, and 9, 6. So here's the graph of g of x. Notice from the function, every y-coordinate on the green function is 2 times the y-coordinate of the blue function. So we say the green function has been stretched vertically by a factor of 2. Now let's consider the graph of h of x equals 1 half times the square root of x. Again, our domain is going to be the same because we have the square root of x. So x is greater than or equal to 0. We'll use the same x values, so we'll have 0, 1, 4, and 9. And now we'll find the corresponding y values. When x is 0, y is 1 half times the square root of 0, which is still 0. When x is 1, y is equal to 1 half times the square root of 1, which is 1 half. When x is 4, y is equal to 1 half times the square root of 4, or 1 half times 2, that's 1. And when x is 9, y is equal to 1 half times the square root of 9, which is 1 half times 3, or 3 halves. Now let's plot these points. We have 0, 0, 1, 1 half, 4, 1, and 9, 3 halves. So here's the graph of h of x. Again, comparing this to our parent function, f of x equals the square root of x, notice how the y-coordinates are half the y-coordinates of the parent function. This is called a vertical compression by a factor of 1 half. Let's go ahead and summarize the vertical stretch and compression. If we have y equals a times f of x, where a is greater than 1, we have a vertical stretch by a factor of a. This was our function g of x equals 2 times the square root of x. And if we have y equals a times f of x, where a is between 0 and 1, we have a vertical compression by a factor of a. This was our function h of x equals 1 half times the square root of x. So we had a vertical stretch in green and a vertical compression in red. Now let's consider g of x equals the square root of 2x. Notice how now the 2 is underneath the square root. Notice how now the 2 is underneath the square root. Now for the domain of this, we know that 2x must be greater than or equal to 0. If we divide both sides by 2, our domain is still going to be x is greater than or equal to 0. However, because we want the radicand of the number underneath the square root to be a perfect square, we are going to use different x values. If x is 0, our radicand will still be 0. If we want the radicand to be 1, we'll have to let x equal 1/2. If we want the radicand to be 4, we'll let x equal 2. If we want the radicand to be 9, we'll have to let x equal 9/2. And now let's find the corresponding y values. When x is 0, y is equal to the square root of 2 times 0, which is the square root of 0, or 0. When x is equal to 1/2, y is equal to the square root of 2 times 1/2, which is the square root of 1, or 1. When x is equal to 2, y is equal to the square root of 2 times 2, or the square root of 4, which is 2. And when x is equal to 9/2, y is equal to the square root of 2 times 9/2, which is equal to the square root of 9, or 3. Let's plot our points. We have 0, 0, 1/2, 1, 2, 2, 9/2, 3, or 4.5, 3, and here's the graph of our function. Now this does kind of look like a vertical stretch upward, but if we look at our table of values, notice how the x-coordinates have been compressed, and it's been compressed horizontally in this direction. So we say we have a horizontal compression. Now we may be thinking this is a horizontal compression by a factor of 2 because of this 2, but it's actually by a factor of 1/2. If we take a look at our table of values, notice how the x-coordinates are half the x-coordinates of the parent function with the same function values. So the scale factor is actually the reciprocal of this 2 here, or 1/2. Now let's take a look at h of x equals the square root of 1/2 x. Again, in this case, our domain is still going to be x greater than or equal to 0, but we are going to be careful about what x values we select for our table. We'll still start with 0, but if we want the number underneath the square root, or the radicand, to be 1, we'll have to let x equal 2. If we want the radicand to be 4, we'll have to let x equal 8. If we want the radicand to be 9, we'll have to let x equal 18. So if x is 0, y is equal to the square root of 1/2 times 0, or 0. When x is 2, y is equal to the square root of 1/2 times 2, or the square root of 1, that's 1. When x is 8, y is equal to the square root of 1/2 times 8, or the square root of 4, that's 2. And when x is equal to 18, y is equal to the square root of 1/2 times 18, or the square root of 9, which is 3. Let's plot our points. We have 0, 0, we have 2, 1, and we have 8, 2. Of course, 18, 3 is off the screen. So here's the graph of h of x. Again, the horizontal stretch and compressions are a little bit trickier. Notice how the red graph would be a horizontal stretch of the blue graph. So we have a horizontal stretch, and because this coefficient is 1/2, it's by a factor of 2. Notice how the x-coordinates are twice the x-coordinates of the parent function with the same y-values, or function values. Now let's summarize the horizontal stretch and compression. If y is equal to f of bx, where b is greater than 1, the graph will be a horizontal compression, which we had as g of x equals the square root of 2x. And if y is equal to f of bx, where b is between 0 and 1, we have a horizontal stretch, which we had h of x equals the square root of 1/2 x. In each case, from the parent function, we multiply the x-coordinate by 1 over b, which is the reason why our scale factors were the reciprocal of what we might have thought. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.